hand if you want a card to ask a question. One of the two gentlemen will come and give you a card. You'll write out your question, hold it in the air again, they'll bring it up. I will sort them, I will ask the questions. My brain is fried and so is my voice. It's Sunday, but let's get started.
It's encouraged to draw a picture on your question.
Pardon me?
Even better if your question comes with a drawing.
Yes, if your question comes with a drawing or is from a kid, it stands more chance of being asked. But while those questions are being written out, if I could ask you to introduce yourselves in terms of the characters that you voice on My Little Pony.
Oh, me? Oh, sure. Hi.
As if these people don't know.
Of course. My name is Andrea, and I voice Pinkie Pie and Fluttershy. Where am I? Who am I? On My Little Pony. As well as a few others, like Pumpkin Cake and Bonbon and Miss Cake or Mrs. Pinkie Pie's mom. Cloudy Quartz. The Seedling that crops. Pinkie Pie sounds like this. Okie dokie, Lucky!
I'm Shannon, and I sing for Pinkie Pie, and I play Silver Spoon, and I also am Lemon Zest.
Yes, hi sis. How are you doing, Every Pony? So glad to be here today. Wow, what a great fandom. I am Ellie Ray. Wow, okay, you're fantastic. And I knew... done probably three episodes playing Mistbane, who's one of the pillars in the Legends, and I also play a couple of changelings. More to come, but it's exciting.
This is your very first My Little Pony convention.
It is.
It is. Huge round of applause. Welcome.
I love you all.
She's got those like that. Well, yesterday anyway, she had that first convention face. Which is this.
Well, because of the meat festival. That was my first. And I've never seen more meat in my entire life. It was incredible.
Is it anyone else's first convention?
Wow.
So this is a fun question to get things started with. Have you ever used your magnificent voice acting powers for evil? Or to prank someone, or that sort of thing?
It's story time.
I just get a lot of, you know, the calls. You get a call and it says, oh, is your mom or dad there? Aww. I just go, haha, no, trying to hang up.
Never really evil, but sometimes if I'm in like a bad mood, I'll switch into Whitney and Britney Biscuit. And I'm like, oh.
Oh, I do evil. I play a lot of, I voice a lot of male characters, monsters. A lot of crazy, my voice is she, he, it's, and they're evil, and some of my friends get me to scare people. They'll say, you know, leave this message, be a male voice, and tell somebody off. And it's just fun.
Question for Andrea. Was it tough doing a Valley Girl accent while voicing Lily Lace?
No, Valley Girl is the best kind of accent. It's just so fun to be there. I love seeing a Valley Girl.
I feel like it like it's second nature.
Yeah.
I'm going to hear that and the biscuit wind playing back and forth.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Where are you from? Are they Valley Girls too?
In fairness, I mean, this is something that folks might not know, but that you record your lines for the episodes a good year and a half before the episodes actually air, so it might be difficult for you to record specific characters or episodes.
It is, yeah. And a lot of times the name will change before it comes out because there's so many legal processes to a name actually coming out. So in our script, I might just say Pony Number 3. And then later, it's like, oh, remember when you played
Or you'll do a character like Mist Maid, who was introduced as the young, beautiful pony with all the magic and all the beauty, and then you have to be the old, wizened sorceress later. So you're trying to be the young voice of her, but remember what it is, because remember when I came back, I was the old.
Yeah.
I was the old one, so she's got two.
You know who she was, Debbie?
Old voice, but I was like, what? Because when I auditioned for her, I auditioned for her as a younger version of herself, and then an ancient version of herself.
Which shall we go with?